The president did finally weigh in on this Coast Guard lieutenant's alleged massacre plot. What did he say on that?
That's right, Brooke. This is the first time that this so-called white supremacist Coast Guard has been weighed in on by the president. He said that it's a shame, a very sad thing when a thing like that happened. He said that he thinks his language is very nice. He denied that, you know, his rhetoric could have inspired this person who's been described as a domestic terrorist who had a hit list that included Democrats, that included media figures. And some critics have said that perhaps the incendiary rhetoric used by President Trump and his allies could have created the environment in which this Coast Guard official allegedly did develop this plan for a mass killing. But of course, President Trump not taking responsibility for that, saying that it's not his fault. This was an isolated incident. White House officials throughout the day had sort of shied away from weighing in on this, from taking any responsibility, commenting on the link to President Trump. So this was the first we heard President Trump condemning the attack, but not accepting responsibility for his rhetoric, Brooke.
Here was the president.
City, yes, sir.
Mr. President, when were you briefed, sir, on the Coast Guard member who was arrested for threatening Democrats and other members of the
I'm actually getting a very final briefing and a very complete briefing in about 2 hours
and
after
this. Do you have any thoughts on this man?
I think it's a shame.
After members
yeah, I think it's a very sad thing when a thing like that happens. And I've expressed that, but I'm actually getting a very complete briefing in about 2 hours.
Do you think that you bear any responsibility for moderating your language when it comes to that?
No, I don't. I think my language is very nice.
Yes. Mr. President,
yes.
From People's
from
Day,
China. China. From China.
Trade conflict has been 1 year, not negotiations going on. So what's your...
So it was the It's a Shame soundbite that I wanted to be able to play, talking about this, you know, white supremacist Coast Guard lieutenant and this, you know, plot to massacre so many people. And so the president, you know, until 5 seconds ago, essentially, hadn't weighed in on it, but was, you know, quick to jump in on, say, Jussie Smollett.
Yeah, again, you know, if you're waiting to determine all the facts, I think we saw a lot of politicians might want to be doing that more. Chris Eliza wrote a great piece this week about how people are rushing to weigh in and offer condemnation before they know what's happening. That's fine. And if you're Donald Trump, waiting normally is a good thing, but he waits and he picks and chooses on what he waits in or what he weighs in on. And that's ultimately the problem. And so then when he gives a milquetoast, well, it's a shame, it obviously seems as not doing enough and picking and choosing his battles.